time for the Ericaism of the day. All right, so I am always busy and I'm always, you know, doing a bunch of things and, you know, and it kind of consumes me and I feel good about the work I do. Before I started this radio show, and you know, I would always pray, Lord, I would walk through whatever door you opened for me. But what I realize now that I've walked through a lot of doors, that how I walk through is very important. If I walk through uninformed and uneducated, it can lend itself to me being more frustrated than I have to be. So even when God gives you an opportunity, it's still your responsibility to be professional and to be equipped. So, you know, whether you are whatever field you're in, timeliness is still very important. How you treat the people you work with is still very important. I'm sure you've seen that meme where there's like a tip of an iceberg, but beneath it, there's this massive chunk of ice, and it's always related to the amount of work that gets done. So I end up on stages and I'll be there maybe 30 minutes, sometimes 90 minutes, depending on what they've asked me to do. But the amount of work that happens before I get there is extremely important. The amount of emails that Misty has to send, or the amount of phone calls that Warren or my manager Dan has to make, are massive. And if those dealings and if that communication is horrible, then when I get there, it's gonna be a bit of a struggle. Don't be the one that's difficult all the way up to the event. Don't be the one that they go, oh my God, they're calling again, because you ask questions because you didn't look at the emails and get the information that they already sent you, or you're asking things that you should be researching first because they've asked you to do a certain thing, whether you are speaking at a church or coming to a school or helping with a nonprofit event. Don't be the difficult one, because it will determine whether you get called back. And sometimes they may call you back, but they don't enjoy you. And I'm not saying everybody has to enjoy you, but at least be someone who works well, who works with integrity, who has character, you know, who is responsible for their actions, who is prepared when they get there. There is nothing, I'm a singer, there is nothing worse than getting to an event that that you knew you were coming to, that was a big deal for somebody else, and you were a guest and you did not know the song. That is so disrespectful. To do that to someone else's event, it's also disrespectful to go to work and have no clue of what you're doing. So do your research. Make sure you're being professional. If you're out there and you're starting a business, it's going to matter to you in a different way being on time. It's going to matter to you in a different way showing up and getting there. It is your job to find the information, not anybody else's. I remember working with a play when I was in the plays years ago, and I was talking to an older gentleman who was worked in the legal field, and I was saying a lot of these people are crooks and a lot of these people trying to get over you, and he said a lot of these people just have more knowledge than you, and because you feel bad that you didn't know, you make them a crook. They weren't a crook, they just had more information than you. And so you can't demonize somebody for being more educated than you. It's not their job to come negotiate for them and for you. It's your job to have the information. So what, no matter what business you are in, be prepared, be equipped, do your research, do your studying, find out what you really want to do, find out what you really want. You do not get what you deserve, you get what you negotiate. All right, that's not necessarily spiritual, but it's some natural tips that I think will actually bless your life. That is my Ericaism for today, ladies and gentlemen. Woo!